Hey, there you go. I pulled it all apart. Excuse me. We have an idea of where all those wires are going to go. But I was trying to explain to Nick on the phone. And it's difficult sometimes to explain what's going to have to happen. Okay, so what we want to do is we want to make sure that works. But when I clean up all those terminals, and try and make that better, and reconnect the wires, in order to test it, I have to connect the pickup. Where did that go? It's here somewhere. There it is. I have to connect the actual piezo. Now to do that, for a test, well, I can't drag it through there, pull the wires out there, and connect them, because that is screwed. And there's no point in, like I said, I'm really worried that, yeah, I'll get that cleaned up once, connect the pickup to it, and then have to disconnect it. It's driving me nuts. I hate doing things twice. We're going to take that off the guitar. And that's the poor man's tool. Stand by. So you saw the cardboard buildup. Someday when I grow up, I'll have those. Maybe we can. Hold on. You're not even in the movie. For Christ's sakes. What was I saying? Someday I'll have that expensive little heater that you can buy. How did we ever live before that? Anyway, we only want to heat that. We don't want to blemish that. This is just some corrugated cardboard. And you can't use any sticky stuff because you're going to heat it. So I got tiny little pieces of tape on the corner. Pack it up with those. Balance that guy on there. Oh, my back. Another reason that I can't work in the film industry anymore. I don't have any more back. Attempting to plug it in. Now my back is fucking frozen down here. Now I'm down here working like this for the rest of the day. Okay, so I like permanent press B. Well, maybe B and a half. It's a small venue. We don't want to blow them out of their seats. And we'll try not to pass out while that's cooking. And I got to find the rest of my palette knives and get ready. I don't think it's going to take much if that glue releases at all. There's a lot of gaps underneath there anyway, so. Fun times, hold on. The games begin. If you see smoke, well, you're holding it wrong. Well, I can smell it, and it's cooking. Oh, there, I'm lucky. I found the rest of those palette knives. We'll look at those in a minute. So like I was saying, this is sort of an expensive one that's really thick. And they sell that for pulling off a bridge plate. But like I said, these are from an art store and they're actually thinner. And this one, as I explained, I to use it to push glue inside a guitar, I took the handle off it. It worked quite great. So I think we're equipped. I smell French fries. Let's see what's going on. Right about now, your sister's wondering where the iron is. So she can... I smell something. Let's try it. Multiple pile of cutlery standing by. Okay, I'm gonna take that guy off. And like I said, I have no idea what kind of glue. Well, there's a whole lot of condensation happening there. Let's try my original guy first. It's sliding in. Oh, it's all gooey. This is bad. Oh, I hope you're getting all this. Try this guy. Get him in. And you only want to go halfway. Yeah, it's going to come right off here in about 2 seconds. This is all... Whoop, there we go. Slid too far. Danger of going all the way through is that you're going to splinter the finish. So there we go. Woo, and she's warm. Pausing. So the whole thing came apart like a bad plumbing repair. It's like there's so little glue, and when you look closely, like there's no glue on that wood, and there is absolutely no glue on that wood surface. And basically they put some spudger on the edge. This is unbelievably bigger than the area where the finish is removed. And but you can see like how much it pulled, like it was like this thing just melted. Okay, so what'll have to happen, I'll clean that shit off there and we'll see what will have to happen. Well, that's just a kick in the sack. Come on, guys. Look, can you actually see how far the whole thing pulled off the guitar? I don't think the electronic guy did this. I think this came from manufacturing, but here I'll demonstrate how fucking stupid this is. Sorry for my language, PG-13. Okay, so that's where the bridge plate should sit. I hope my pencil line worked out, or this whole shot's a waste of time. Yeah, that's how much material didn't get removed. So I can't cut that. Like, I can't shear it because I'll crack what's next to it. So we're gonna have to run a, actually, like, I just eyeballed this. I want to make sure that that's actually where this bridge plate needs to sit, and we'll push some tapered dowels down those holes and just line all this back up again. So the only way to do this is to score it with a blade, and then I'll take a Dremel tool and very carefully remove all that shit so that that can actually be wood glued to wood. Thank you, Godin. Happy to rebuild your guitars for you. Stay tuned. We'll be back soon. Yeah, so big shout out to the people at LR Bags. They came up with that. Like I said, I have a diagram of the circuit board that tells me wires go where. But this is unacceptable. And at this point, you know, this is one of those guitars that needs to go to the Museum of Guitars. But that's how much this, and I think they've cut this after the fact. Maybe I'm wrong. Anybody knows? Hey, anybody that works for Godin, tell me how you let this pass QC and how glue suspended in frickin' midair is supposed to glue to something. That's a joke. Come on. Okay, but we'll fix it. Till next time, folks. Cheers. Thanks for all the support. Please take a minute, look at my Patreon thing, try and understand what's going on. I'm not looking for handouts. I'm looking for a way to help everybody and give back, and it'll all be good. I'm telling you. T-shirts are coming. Stickers are coming. It's all going to be great. Cheers.